Hello everybody, Bromatic here. Welcome back to another video. And today, I'm listening to Drake's diss track on Kendrick and everybody else and Rick Ross's response. This isn't dropped officially yet, so and you guys motherfuckers could not wait, so you leaked it, so I might as well go over it before it drops on Friday when literally nobody's going to be listening or paying attention to it, so... You know, fuck it. Anyways, let's fucking get it. I've heard that Drake cooked, which seems impossible. So, let's fucking get this. All right, let's get it. Push-ups, aka drop and give me 50. Both got lyric videos. Links to them in the description. Let's get it. I don't think this is gonna kill Kendrick. Kendrick is gonna murder him back. Hey, I could never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't never take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man's on? This the part with the bite, nigga, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby, hope red, you been shook up. Okay. This top toe you drop it, give me 50 likes of push-ups. Cool, your last one brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you because they split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop
okay.
And give them 50.
Why are you... Okay, I gotta pause it. Sorry, I usually don't pause it, but why are you dissing Kendrick for giving a verse to what, Maroon 5 and Taylor Swift? How is that a diss? He's just giving verses to people that are popular. Like, I don't know, maybe because he's trying to make money, or maybe because they're popular. I don't know. Get more fans. Could be. I don't know, Drake. The fuck? I'm sure you have a verse on some shit that you're... This is the same thing. Like, what? At least he writes his verses. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm getting a little pissed. Because it just... This is not a good diss track so far. There's not really anything that really is, like, deep so far. He's just making up... Or not making up, but, like, just... saying some weak ass bars. I don't understand how this is supposed to hurt Kendrick, but anyway, let's keep going. Pip squeak pipe down, you ain't in no big three. Scissor got you wiped down. Travis got
okay.
You wiped down. Savage
okay.
Got you wiped down.
Like a label boy right. In a scope right now. If okay, that's a cool that's a bar. I'm at the top okay, of the mountain so tight now. Just to add his talk with your ass, I had to hike down. Big difference between Mike then and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20v1, nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. Get more love in a city that you fun, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Yeah. Okay, what the fuck? What the actual fuck? Metro, make some drums. Okay, dude. Metro makes insane beats, so I don't know how you're dissing Metro for making great beats. Some of the best beats in this generation. And like literally you just listed 21 Savage as top three, and most of the reason why he is top three is because of Metro Boomin's beats. So, Drake, how does that make sense? And then let me see the bars back here. SZA's not top three. She's definitely top three women rappers, not top three all time. Savage isn't top three. Travis maybe. Travis is the only one I'll give you. What's a prince to a king? He's a son. That's a bar. All right, let's keep going. The city that you run, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Yeah, I'm the sixth guy. I'm the front runner. Y'all nigga manager was Charles' little blunt runner. Clean a six and you boys ain't even come from it. Bodyguards like Whitney. Top say drop your little midget ass. Better fucking. Hey, better drop and give me 50. Hey, drop and give me 50. Drop and give me 50. Hey, niggas really got me out here talking like I'm 50. Niggas really got me out here rapping what I'm living. I might take your latest girl a cuffer like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in, this nigga turning 50. Every song that made it on a
okay,
track.
You're old as fuck too. That check, no, that's just not.
Business, nigga. Shout out to the hooper that be
busting out the grid. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm heating up. I don't care what Cole think, that dot shit was weak as fuck. Champagne tripping, he is not fucking easing up. Keeping up, begging cops or not, boy, you not fucking beating us. Numbers wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking creeping up. Money wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking sneaking up. Cornball, your show money, merch money, feed us.
Cornball? Drake, you cannot call Kendrick a cornball. You motherfucker are the corniest motherfucker on this planet. Oh my God. There's no... Like, what? There's no way he's calling him a cornball. Huh? You just name drop Kaisen at in a diss track. That's corny. What the fuck are you on about, brother? And then the dot shit was weak? No, it wasn't. There's a reason why you have a diss track against it, because clearly it hurt you, and clearly a lot of people thought that it killed you. So I'm just saying, so far none of these bars are on par with what Kendrick said to him. So, and every song that made it on the chart he got from Drizzy. Come on, Drake, bro. We all know that you do not write most of your songs, dude. It just came out that Lil Yachty wrote Jumbotron shit poppin'. Like, bro. Huh? I know there's probably a reference track for a song that Kendrick has, but Drake, I'm pretty sure, I don't know how true this is, but I'm pretty sure your Sicko Mode verse was ghostwritten as well, from what I saw. But all right, whatever you want to say.
This ain't even everything I know, don't waste the demon up.
It's not everything Kendrick knows either. What about Millie Bobby Brown? Okay. Okay.
Drop a 50 bag for the mob in a spot. Drop a 50 bag, 29 for the thought. I was really, really trying to keep it PG.
That's ass. Okay, that last part, terrible. Absolutely horrible. Drake, what the fuck was that? This sounds like AI. I'm not going to lie. I kind of hope it is AI, because that was really weak, in my opinion. Most of the shit that he says applies to him as well. Like, 10 times. Like, what? All right, bro. You had some good lines in there. I wonder who wrote them for you. I know I am a Drake hater, but, like, come on, bro. Like, none of those bars were... Like, there's some creative bars and good bars in there. But they just weren't really, like... I don't know. They didn't hit as hard as, like, fuck the top three, it's just Big Me, or for all the dogs getting buried, you're going to see Pet Cemetery. Like, dude, come on. Like, what? And you cannot say Kendrick's last album was a flop, because he literally... His lowest scoring album is higher than your highest scoring album. Like, what? You got it. You're tripping, Drake. Aubrey Graham, you're tripping. I'm just saying that for real. You are fucking tripping. Let's get into this fucking Rick Ross one. Hopefully this shit's better. Alrighty. Let's get into it. It's called Champagne Moments. Let's get it.
Fish tanks and marble floors, living big and bad. Niggas laugh until they hit with my official jab. Crack smoke is the exhaust from my pen and pad. Ghost writers, they get the floss. What you could
already
had.
Killing
them. Record label taking a loss. Are you in your bag? You mean you check me?
He's calling Drake a white boy.
White boy, I see you.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, check. Getting bullied, don't walk up on me because the clip is fully. Niggas pussy don't want to push me. I'm like, really, Woody? Like his moves. But he never had a fight in school. Always ran another nigga had to write your grooves.
Damn.
Was copying your pace. Weezy gave you the juice. Another white boy at the park want to hang with the crew. Pull it surprise winner switching up like dyed denim. Getting sentenced for all the killings while we ride rentals. Look me right in my face. He beginning to shake. Told you niggas stay scheming. I predicted my fate. Got more money than you. Fuck you want me to say? You check me.
By the way, I got a lot of respect for a lot of rappers, but I got one guy. He's my favorite person to rap for any song. His name is Rick Ross.
Fuck off.
You never want to be a nigga anyway, nigga. That's why you had operation to make your nose smaller than your father knows, nigga. I don't follow you.
Not real.
Said the motherfucking cease and desist, the French Montana, nigga.
Is that real?
This nigga hating on my dog project. That one the same white boy that I seen, nigga, when we were making them early records, nigga. When you were happy to be around, nigga, seeing niggas so fucking stunning your life, nigga. Give Weezy some more money, nigga. Give Rap-A-Lot some more money, nigga. White boy, yeah, biggest. It's Rosé, nigga. We can do it how you want to do it, where you want to do it, anytime you want to do it. I'm ready. I'm ready, white boy. Huh? I know you got your Dockers on with no underwear, white boy. Yeah, you had that surgery, that six-pack going. That's why you wearing that funny shit at your show. You can't hide it, nigga. White boy.
Damn. Okay. Okay. Miles better. Miles better. Not as a song, but as a diss track. That is important. Okay, so Drop and Give Me 50 is supposed to mean that 50% of profits from Kendrick's music goes to Anthony Top Tiffiths, who's the CEO of his former label, and therefore have been legally extorted throughout his music career. Okay. All right. Okay, get more money and get more love in the city that you're from. Cool, cool, cool. Yeah, okay, it was just a weak diss in general, I'm not gonna lie. I mean, I am even reading into the lyrics, I'm still not really seeing anything that's, like, crazy. I mean, big difference between Mike then and Mike now is cool. Like, this is the first time Drake's actually openly, like, non-subliminally dissed somebody, so clearly it hurt him. Rick Ross's was just way better. Diss-wise, it was way better. I think I would rather listen to Drake's song again, but it's not like, I don't know, I feel like it's not as hurtful as Rick Ross's is. And I feel like Rick Ross and Kendrick both have a lot more that they could use on Drake. A lot more. So, I don't know, man. I feel like they're both weaker than I expected them to be. They're both not really like any kill shot shit like Eminem did. But, I mean, I think so far Drake's not winning still. Because apparently Rick Ross dropped his literally hours after Drake dropped his. So he had this probably prepared just in case he was going to diss Rick Ross, and he did. So, you know. Kendrick, I'm waiting for your response, and I think you're going to kill this man. So please do that. Drake is so overrated. I think he is the most overrated artist out of anybody. Especially new Drake. Especially new Drake. For All the Dogs was some garbage. Oh my God. There was good songs on that, sure. But most of it was just so bad. I could not stand that album most of the time. Same thing with especially Honestly Nevermind. Honestly Nevermind is one of the worst albums I've ever heard. So, I don't know, man. This beef is interesting to me, especially because I genuinely already did not really like Drake's music, so I kind of think it's funny to see him get shit on. I don't really care who wins here. I know who's going to, because Kendrick is Kendrick. He is a Pulitzer Prize, like, seriously. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. See you guys in the next one. Peace out.